My name is Professor Michio Kaku. I'm a professor of theoretical physics at the City College and the City University of New York. When we smash protons apart with the Large Hadron Collider, we get particles, more particles. There are hundreds, thousands of subatomic particles we get by smashing protons apart. So isn't there a simple theory that explains all these things into a simple fabric? Well, we have the Large Hadron Collider, which has pretty much verified what is called the Standard Model. But the Standard Model is ugly. It's perhaps one of the ugliest theories known to science. It's like taking an aardvark, a platypus, and a whale and scotch taping it together and claiming that this is nature's finest evolutionary creation, the most beautiful animal created by Mother Nature. Well, even the people who created the Standard Model of particles thinks that it's ugly and that the ultimate theory should be beautiful. It should be elegant. And that's what Einstein was looking for. And that's what we think string theory is. Einstein wanted an equation perhaps no more than 1 inch long that would allow him to, quote, read God's thoughts. Well, today we can summarize string theory into an equation about 1 inch long, and that's my equation. That's string field theory, which allows us to describe all of string theory into a simple framework of an equation 1 inch long. Einstein gives us a picture that the universe is a bubble of some sort. We live on the skin of the bubble, and the bubble is expanding. That's called the Big Bang theory, the dominant theory in all of cosmology. But string theory predicts more. It says that there could be other bubbles out there. There could be a bubble bath of universes. And when these universes collide and create a bigger universe or they fission, that's the Big Bang. And so people have often asked the question, what happened before creation? What happened before Genesis chapter 1, verse 1? What happened before the beginning of time itself? Well, if the universe was created by budding baby bubbles, then that's what happened before the Big Bang. There's a continual bifurcating of universes. This fits the data. This is not just some silly science fiction story. It fits what is called inflationary theory. Think of a gigantic bubble that constantly peels off lots of baby bubbles so that Big Bangs happen all the time. That is called the inflationary universe, which in turn fits all the data. And the inflationary universe theory in turn is compatible with string theory. So we have a simple picture that puts it all together. This bubble bath of universes called the multiverse of universes, governed by string theory, which in turn allows us to describe the splitting or the bifurcating of universes. And then people ask me the question, if there are these parallel universes, then is Elvis Presley still alive in one of these parallel universes? Well, it can't be ruled out. The physics says that yes, there's a certain probability that Elvis Presley is still alive in one of these parallel universes.